imagination. At the bottom, only two clubs, Avellino and Empoli, had been relegated, but four were promoted to introduce a longer 34-game season. Once again, the likes of Pisa, Como and Ascoli were among the strugglers. These were the four new clubs for the First Division. Bologna were promoted as champions, but Lecce only came through after a playoff. Another new innovation was to allow clubs three foreign players, a policy which benefited teams such as Inter, who signed the Bayern Munich duo of Andy Bremer and Lothar Matthäus, a powerhouse in midfield. Torino spent lavishly on the skill of the Brazilian forward Muller. But of course, there were still the established stars, such as Marco van Basten, who'd missed much of his first season in Italy, but would become the 1988 European Footballer of the Year. In that respect, van Basten succeeded his Milan clubmate and fellow Dutch international, Ruud Gullit. And of course, there's always Napoli's Diego Maradona. So sit back and enjoy the goals from the most glamorous league in the world.
Alomar, caught in possession. Pasculi, and taken on the break by Vanoli. A good advantage played by the referee. And Baroni going in! Well, how did he get there? The tall defender suddenly cropping up in the centre. Really a classic break in the Italian style. Vanoli speeding up on the far side, delivering the cross perfectly. And Marco Baroni, who's played for Fiorentina, Udinese and Roma, gives Lecce a flying start.
So Bologna looking to build on their lead. The early goal from Lorenzo coming after only 2 minutes. Foul then on Benetti, and the free kick taken very quickly. Strangara and Marinaro, and it's two. Superb play then by Bologna, and what a start for them on their return to the First Division. A quick piece of thinking here sends Strangara away, and as the cross comes in, the ball arrowed past goalkeeper Grudina by Marinaro. Oh, and Buller has missed his tackle. Here's Vierkevoort. Driving it in, and he scored! Oh, an incredible goal then by Vierkevoort. Buller missed his tackle. Vierkevoort stumbled, but kept his composure. And just look here at the venom of the shot that flew past Lorieri. It's 2-1 to Sampdoria. Zignetti will want that ball absolutely right to face Maradona, but he's curled it in! Magnificently done by Maradona. And the mercurial Argentine has done it again. Just look here at his artistry as he steers the ball round the wall and past the goalkeeper into the corner. Oh, and Baggio is clear here. Now, can he finish? Yes, emphatically so, Roberto Baggio. The Cesena defence all over the place here. And this is as cool a piece of finishing as you could hope to see from Baggio. It's 2-0 to Fiorentina. And this is promising now then for Pisa. Severines to Brandani. And the defender, Brandani, has given Pisa the lead. Great work down the left here by Severines, the Belgian. And it's Brandani in this advanced position to chuck the ball past the goalkeeper. 1-0 to Pisa. Here's Dunga, the Brazilian. Oh, some tricky play from him. Boganovo, and he scored! superbly done by Borgonovo. It's an inspired play from Dunga to set up the chance here, tricking Del Olio. And a spectacular header by Borgonovo.
Diaz takes the corner. Serena came off Andrade, a goal! It's Berti! Trapattoni, very animated on the bench. It might initially have been Serena's goal. He would have thought so when he got to the corner first and flicked it at goal. Andrade blocked it, but there was no stopping the follow-up from Berti.
So Laudrup looking to use his pace. He's held back, but the referee allows the advantage. Taken up here by Rui Barros, and he's scored! 3-0 to Juventus, and what a cheeky goal from Rui Barros. Laudrup was clearly held back. The referee sensibly allowed him to go on. Cross finding Rui Barros. Goalkeeper Kuzin was stranded and passed him as De Mol arrives too late, and the ball in off the post.
Would be something if they could make it 3-3 here. What they have in their favour is 2 5 goal hauls in their home UEFA Cup ties. D'Agostini. Zavarov! 3-2! What a second half it's been so far for Juventus. D'Agostini clipped it in, and Zavarov, running to the near post area, just stretched out hoping to turn it on. He could hardly have expected it to be so perfectly placed. Right inside the post there.
Headed on to Muller. A chance, and he's taken it superbly. Muller with his second goal since arriving in Italy. This is first season, remember. He scored last week against Fiorentina, and as the flick on from Scotto reached him, he turned inside delightfully then and steered the ball past Rossi.
Careca. That was neatly done. On from Fusi for Careca to chase, and he got the better of Favreau. Brio off the line. Back to Careca again, goal! An extraordinary one. 2-0 to Napoli. Careca started it on the halfway line and raced away to the return pass from Fusi and left Favreau, who was, I think, distracted by the goalkeeper, who didn't have any need to come and was still stranded when Brio's clearance went back to Careca. That's 2-0. Tacconi, who can be a little impulsive, and to my mind was then, and Brio was a bit unlucky. He scooped it away, but straight back into danger. And Careca, with great presence of mind, calmly chested it down and threaded in the left-footed shot.
Donadoni, beyond Hullet, oh, what a mistake at the back, and Hullet, an incredible goal! What a shot then by Hullet. On the volley, he must have been almost 25 yards out. Donadoni's pass looked to have gone astray, a blunder at the back. And what a drive by Hullet, and that's some way to score your first goal of the season. Bonomi to Carboni. Sampdoria stringing their passes together well here. Mancini's pass, De Sena chasing, and it's gone in! De Sena, the scorer, under the legs of Landucci. It was Mancini's pass, He's picked De Sena out so well. De Sena hoping for something, and he's got the goal. Away then go Inter, attacking the goal to our right. This is Mateus. Long ball in search of Berti. Mattioli. Oh, he scored! Well, I reckon that is inside 10 seconds. Quite astonishing. And that surely has to be some sort of record. And what a way for Inter to start their birthday celebrations, their 80th anniversary. Betty failed to meet the ball there, but Mattioli most certainly did. It's Corgi to Incociati. Good turn. Oh, good goal too. Expertly done then by Incociati, the new man from Atalanta. And he's proving an inspired signing. He spotted the goalkeeper was off his line and just floated the ball beyond him.
Mancini. Oh, and Carrecas in his own half when the ball was played, so had to be onside. He's streaking away. That's it. That's the 2 points. Arigasaki perhaps was wondering about offside, but when he gets the chance to see it again, he'll know the officials were absolutely right. The ball on its way, Carreca still in his own half until it arrived. And then too quick for those trying to catch him. And the finish was supremely achieved. A striker right at the top of his game. It's his 7th of the season.
Up goes Carboni. Massaro got the better of him. Giannini's up with him, and Rudy Foller. And Massaro keeping running, and he's made no mistake this time. And I wonder whether that will sink Sampdoria here. Massaro, joy and a spot of relief, having wasted a good opportunity early in the half, but Giannini just floated it on. Massaro ran free, and the shot sped into the corner. And Sampdoria staring a home defeat in the face now.
Holmquist bursting down that left flank. Good cross in. Aselli! And the substitute has scored. A rare opportunity for Aselli in the first team. And he's repaid the confidence of the coach. What a fine piece of play here first, though, by Holmquist. And then Aselli in before Giovanelli. And it's 1-0 to Cesena. Tricella taking the chance to come forward. Here's Altobelli. Taking on one defender. They've stood back from him. Oh, and cheekily done. And the old master, Altobelli, such an experienced campaigner, teasing defenders here. They rather stood off from him, and he had time to weigh up the situation. And that's a delightful chip then by Altobelli. So Junior with this free kick for Pescara, and it's there! Junior with a typical piece of Brazilian flair. It's 2-2 now, and I wonder how often down the years Junior has produced a free kick like that one. Oh, and a mistake by Scotto. And Polly is in the clear. A glance across, he's onside, and he's finished it too. Polly kept his head then, looked across, made sure he was still onside. The mistake by Scotto. As the ball was played through, Polly had just stayed onside. It must have been a marginal decision. And Torino have conceded a goal, and their away jinx strikes again.
Cabrini. Zavarov very busy ahead of him. And here's Maro for Altobelli. Galea! A goal really out of nothing, but beautifully engineered. Well, that's what they've been looking for. Technical play of a very high order. A lot of movement, and then Maro into where Altobelli had made a splendid run, and he set up Galea right into his stride.
Pent for Lazio. Here's Ruben Sosa. Oh, magnificent goal from Sosa. His first in Italy. And what a glorious strike then. Just one glance up and then a scorching drive past Zanetti. Sosa the scorer for Lazio. Sorrentino will hope he's got his angles right here against Maradona. But he hasn't. And Maradona yet again has scored from a set piece. His sixth goal of the season. A fair way out here, but he's curled it round the wall, and the goalkeeper stretching can't get there.
Rijka, good anticipation. A lot of good things about this game. When sometimes in derby matches the tension really is all powerful and destroys the attempts to play football, that hasn't been the case here. Bergamy. Serena! It's a brilliant header! A fantastic goal for Inter! From Aldo Serena! Coming after 27 minutes. And Bergamy, coming from deep, played his part. Involved again in the move here. Getting the cross in early, that's just how Serena likes it. And the header was angled to perfection beyond the flailing arms of Giovanni Galli. A deep corner, it's Tassotti who hit it superbly! What a great goal! Mauro Tassotti, the Milan defender who was actually born here in Rome, had a spell with Lazio, had a birthday only 3 days ago, he was 29, and what a way to celebrate it, a magnificent strike, and Milan are in front with a remarkable goal after 7 minutes from Mauro Tassotti.
Carobi cuts inside, but crudely brought down then. A fierce body check by Monti. So a chance here for Fiorentina. It's Baggio. Oh, and he's taken the chance. And a third goal has surely now settled it. Baggio, a clever piece of play from him. Beyond the goalkeeper, Martina. 3-0. Chetti with the free kick. And Simone, a blistering shot, and he's scored. This already vital game down towards the foot of the table. And what an important goal this could turn out to be. The defensive wall simply didn't do enough. And it's 1-0 to Como. Cross in was from Bianchi. And Bremer going in very strongly, and finishing strongly too. Bremer, who's having an outstanding first season in Italian football since his arrival from Bayern Munich. And this was an awesome piece of shooting from Andy Bremer.
Giannini, confronted by Carinante. Massaro. Tempestilli getting the cross in a bit quicker this time. Rudy Völler! Unbelievable! timely. And Tempestilli played a major part with a great cross. And the header matched it.
Giovanelli, and he's picked out Giordano. Round the goalkeeper, and it's 2-0. Cavone committed, and Giordano taking full advantage. It's a lovely through ball by Giovanelli, and some tidy and composed finishing by Giordano. And that surely now has made life very difficult for Verona. 2-0 down.
Policano. Now Nela. And who will it drop for now? Desideri and Massaro both there. Giannini. Massaro right into the puck. Manfredonia. And again, some heroic defending. Völler! Oh, the post and away! An extraordinary escape. Roma have come no closer. And how frustrating for them when they finally did beat Tacconi. One of his goalposts came to the rescue. And here's Rui Barros. Laudrup, he's onside, and it's 2-0, and the counter-attack has worked again, and Rui Barros, who made the first goal, has scored the second as Roma look in vain to the linesman who kept his flag down. It was the timing of the run here by Laudrup, and he was onside. It was brilliantly timed. So too was the run into the centre to collect the goal from Rui Barros.
Mancini riding one tackle. Here's Vialli trying to work a combination with Mancini. Vialli continuing his run, and Vialli has scored. Well, he missed a similar chance earlier in the half, but no mistake this time. Mancini, his front-running partner, involved in the build-up, and the two combining so effectively again. An almost telepathic understanding between them at times. Mancini finding Vialli, and the golden boy of Italian football strikes again. Simone controlled it well, and he spotted Milton through the middle here, and a goal from Milton! His first in Italian football. Some creative play and thoughtful play, certainly, from Simone. He picks out Milton, striding into the penalty area. And although Lorieri gets a hand to it, he can't prevent the ball from going in. Bain. His committed defenders. Oh, yes! What a goal from Mario Bain. Well, Pisa found it so difficult to score goals this season. They've really struggled, but Bain made it look easy then. Great turn. And what a finish.
Baresi again, just a hopeful hook forward. Vidis holds it up. Turns away from Oddi. Finds Evani. Well, it's got forward this time, but the cross was not hit deep enough. Maldini, Evani can try again. This time Vidis has made a move into the middle and finds Van Basten. He's onside and he scores this time. A much more difficult chance. But Milan have regained the lead. Joy mixed with relief for the scorer. But look at the roll from Vidis. A perfect touch. It was Manfredonia who played him onside. And a quality goal from the Milan viewpoint, although Roma will be very disappointed in the way they defended there.
Bologna urgently need a goal to haul themselves back into contention, and they might find one here. Yes, to Mol. The Pescara defenders in a terrible tangle, two of them here going for the same ball. De Mol backing off them, left unmarked, and the Belgian international driving the ball in. They're back in the game. Girolin with the free kick for Roma. Way by Hussein, but only as far as Massaro. Yes! Marvellous piece of opportunism by Massaro. The man, remember, they signed from Milan. Girolin there with the free kick. Hussein's header, none too effective really. Straight to Massaro. And he's given Roma the lead.
Inter being told to retreat the correct distance. Fritz to take it. And a free header and a goal for Emaier. He's answered the Atalanta call yet again. They're off the bench. Scenes of great jubilation here in Bergamo. And how simply the goal arrived. And Inter's most disciplined marking, totally absent. Alamar. Cannavale. Reggiano was strong in the tackle, but then showed too much of the ball to Renica. Cannavale. Renica goes on to make the extra player in the move, should he be required. Here he is. Oh, and Cannavale has rounded it all off. Well, he's done in the second half exactly what he did in the first, given Napoli a goal right at the outset. And these are some celebrations. And I just wonder, Cannavale started the move in his own half. Some Italian players have bonuses in their contracts if they get 10 goals in a season. And this is number 10 for Cannavale.
Cavalli breaking through now. Here's Vialli. Is this the third? Well, that's quality finishing by Vialli. And Sampdoria, from being a goal down, have now taken a 3-1 lead. Set up by Cavalli, Vialli turns his marker and drives the ball into the far corner. And Juventus have got plenty of players forward here. Altobelli's pass. Rui Baros. The goalkeeper completely committed then, Rossi. The opening work by Altobelli and finished off by Rui Baros. 1-0 to Juventus. Vierkovod on from Pari. Vialli, here's Mancini. Oh, lovely goal from Mancini. It's 4-1 now, and this is turning into something of a rout. Pari, the early ball on for Vialli, down for Mancini, and he had time here to pick his spot perfectly. Mattioli looking for Diaz, hits it first time! What a goal from Ramon Diaz! Well, the Argentine has his critics at Inter Milan, but he'll receive nothing but plaudits for this shot. 1-0 to Inter.
Donadoni forced infield and into trouble. Colombo. Rather a lucky ricochet that took the ball to Angelo Colombo, and he can try one and finds the perfect shot. Angelo Colombo, with half-time almost upon us. His first goal of the season, and he'll find it hard to better over the months ahead. It was a beauty. Finding himself one-on-one here with Battistini, and he was prepared to take him on as though it was a training exercise. Switched it to the left foot, bent it just inside the post, no chance for the goalkeeper.
Corneliusson. Corradini missed his tackle, another mistake too, and Simone is in here. And he's going all the way, and he's beat Giuliani and scored. It's a classic goal from Simone. Just 20 years old, he's one of the most promising young players in Italian football. Two mistakes then by the Napoli defenders. But Simone had the presence of mind to check, cut inside, take defenders on. And the shot past Giuliani. Here's the corner. Pacioni! A stupendous header that gives Verona the lead. Well, they haven't found it easy to score goals this season. And that's a very welcome boost for the goals for tally. Pacioni.
Hussein. Well, it's really looking now the accomplished performer we know he is. He wasn't that way with a succession of injuries at the start of the season. This is Ancelotti. Oh, they've done it again. Another goal from midfield. Another one that will live long in the memory. Carlo Ancelotti. Well, we've seen him do it before. And Landucci can feel aggrieved. He's been beaten twice now from distance by excellent shots. That carried too much force for the goalkeeper. Possibly that replay indicating that he might have done a little better with it. He had no chance with the first goal. He had a reasonable side of this one, but it was too powerful for him.
Well, it's a poor clearance. Here's Pecci, now for Monza. Well, they've missed several opportunities, but at last Monza has succeeded in accepting one of them. Pecci, the provider, threading the ball through, appeals in vain for offside. The goalkeeper couldn't stop it going in. Carboni. Cerezo got a touch on. Well, they've got themselves in a tangle at the back. Mancini! Well, his critics say he doesn't score enough goals, but when he does, they do tend to be rather spectacular. Cerezo with a touch on. Poor defensive play, and Mancini with a spanking shot.
Giannini. Roma playing with two out-and-out forwards. Rudy Fowler, the number nine. And Ruggiero Rizzitelli, who hasn't been a regular since his move at the start of the season from Cesena. An expensive signing, too. Here's Massaro coming in. Oh, that's a wonderful goal! A really terrific goal by Daniele Massaro. A spanking volley. And after 3 minutes, really, of sparring here in Bergamo, Roma have landed the first punch, and it really took Atalanta by surprise. Magnificent technique to reach the dropping ball with such a stunning shot. Atalanta running out of time. In from Bonaccina. Ferrario gets a toe to it. Massaro, whose third-minute goal was really an inspiring moment for Roma. But they still face a few more anxious seconds. Played wide by Serioli. And this is Madonna, and that is an absolutely fabulous equaliser. Right out of the blue, right at the last, Armando Madonna. What a fantastic goal. And the two players who came here in November from Piacenza combining, it was Serioli who played the pass wide. A useful decoy run from Pritz, allowing Madonna to cut the ball back onto his right foot and produce a scoring shot of searing pace. Well, the game started with a terrific goal by Roma, and it looks as though it's finishing here at 2-2. They do tend to sit back and concentrate on the defensive side of their play. Sacchi directing operations from the standing position now. And Hollett too quick for Gutierrez. Van Basten! A very simple goal in its execution. But the heart of the matter was the change of speed that Hollett was able to find. He went into overdrive. And Van Basten had pulled away at the far post, lost his marker in doing so, and sensibly angled the header across the goalkeeper and beyond him. Off went Hollett. And he was too strong as well as too quick for the labouring Gutierrez. And that's a textbook header from Van Basten.
Rui Baros to Gallia. Here's Mauro to Marocchi. And a goal, it's 2-0. Giancarlo Marocchi with the second for Juventus. A well-worked move. Mauro here with the telling pass. And a decisive finish from Marocchi. Now here's Madonna. Whipping in the early cross, Evair, and he scored! The equaliser from the Brazilian Evair. Excellent ball played in by Madonna. And Evair flicking on his eighth goal of the season.
They're picking their passes at will. And they're a class above Juventus at the moment. Tassotti. Colombo assessing what's on in the middle. And finding Hullet. Here's Van Basten. It's 2-0. It's Evani. It's also a stupendous start by the home side. They join in the celebrations in the dugout. A pretty orthodox ball in from Hullet. And Van Basten at the moment is unmarkable. A header down perfectly, and Evani steered it in via the underside of the bar. They can't get close to Marco Van Basten. Favaro was a yard away again. And that created the chance taken with aplomb by Evani.
Baggio with the corner to Pellegrini. Baggio with the cross in. Borgonovo! Season he's having. It's goal number 11 for Borgonovo to make it 3-1 now then to Fiorentina. Cesena rather asleep on the corner, and Borgonovo, a lovely header. Prima. Diaz. Di Marchi, who caught it in possession then. Now, Vanosh, and Laudrup arriving! 4 minutes into the second half, and Michael Laudrup has given Juventus the lead. It all stemmed there from Di Marchi's mistake. Rui Vanos taking full advantage. A glance up, and he sees Laudrup steaming in, and tucked away delightfully. Buro through to Ruben Sosa! It's 1-1. What a lift for Lazio in their efforts to stave off the threat of relegation. A pinpoint pass here from Buro, and Ruben Sosa driving the ball beyond the goalkeeper. 1-1. Ancelotti just touching it off. Here's Hullet! Well, he seems to relish playing against Verona. He scored a brilliant goal against them earlier in the season. And he strikes again here in the most emphatic fashion. Ruud Gullit, what a goal. It's Dunga. Dunga again. This time he's found Baggio. And he's found the corner of the net. Roberto Baggio gives Fiorentina the lead here. Set up by Dunga, as the ball comes back to him here. Atalanta all over the place. And Baggio, a very cool piece of finishing.
And Hullet still prepared to work back to win the ball for Milan. Van Basten. Rijkaard waving players into position. Dassotti, the Olays are coming out now from the crowd. Ancelotti, Juventus on the rack again. Must be so disheartening for them. They can't get close to the ball. Ancelotti, Baresi, Rijkaard. Ancelotti, and here's Donadoni. Oh, they're going to round it all off with a goal. Ah! Oh, fantastic, simply fantastic. And it's Manari, the 19-year-old substitute, came in with a flying header then, after Milan had knocked the ball around for minutes and then suddenly found purpose to go with the possession. Donadoni cut it back, and that was a fabulous goal. One that you could watch again and again. It's Manari's first for Milan in the first division, and if he plays for another 15 years, he'll not get a better one.
Colavati really launched himself into the first headed clearance, then the second came from Policano. Sabato, and Policano wins the ball and gives it away. Scotto, Muller, that's beautiful footwork from Muller. It's a brilliant goal. A moment of real inspiration for Torino. When Roma seemed to have enough defenders back, Colavati was beaten by the first turn, and then the change of direction wrong-footed a whole pack of them. And the shot was true, right into the corner. And that was Brazilian brilliance by Muller. A fabulous goal.
Only a few seconds then remaining in the first half. Dunga's tackle. Dolcetti got caught. Pellegrini back to Dunga, and he scored right on the stroke of half-time. Carlos Dunga. And the Brazilian makes it 3-0 to Fiorentina, putting the game surely now beyond the reach of Pisa. ball from Dolcetti's mistake. And Dunga driving the ball beyond the outstretched arms of Grudina. Here's the free kick. Junior! What a magnificent shot by Junior! It gives Pescara the lead. Another stunning shot by Junior, who remains one of the most feared players from this distance. Now here's Nicolini, Evaier to Serioli, and Barcella! Constanzo Barcella with a second goal for Atalanta. Lovely first time football played here. And Serioli swings over the cross. It's a defender, Barcella, who finishes it off.
They're not really creating very much. A goal down and always vulnerable to the pace in Torino's counter-attacking. Scorro showed too much of the ball then. Giannini. Away goes Rudy Völler. Rossi is with him, but Völler is past him. Still Völler! Well, another outstanding goal from a player who's capable of such moments but hasn't really had the opportunity to do it in a struggling team. But Völler just went on and on. It's 1-1. Torino will question their defending, but let's be fulsome in our praise for Völler's attitude. He took on a posse of defenders and found a way past them.
Pedicini threading it through. Agostini. Yes! The equaliser from Agostini. Pedicini, the former Inter player, sets it up for him. Splitting open the defence. And Agostini tucks it away. Bremer in strongly. Mateus. It's a second goal for Mateus. 3-0 to Inter, who've taken charge of this game now. Mateus, who scored a few minutes earlier from the penalty spot, and he strikes again. Busso to Tricella. And he spotted Kalia. Galea has turned this game around. Juventus, from being a goal down, are now 2-1 up. Rather sloppy defensive play by Sampdoria. Tricella's through ball, and Galea, who missed from a similar situation earlier, makes no mistake this time. Zavarov. Here he is again. Got Busso here, away to his left. Oh, great goal from Busso! Well, there seems no end to the entertainment that these two serve up when they meet each other. 5-3 earlier in the season. Now it's 3-2 to Juventus, thanks to this goal from Busso. Mateus swapping passes with Mattioli. Diaz was in the middle, so to Serena! Serena's 16th goal of the season. What a splendid interchange of passes here. Mateus and Mattioli. Pescara really struggling. And Serena is in brilliant form. Promising spell this for Como. And here's Invonizzi, very promising indeed. And Invonizzi gives Como the lead. Third to bottom before the start of this match, Como. So a real lift for them. Invonizzi with a great goal.
He was pulling Giannini back the required distance. In it goes the second time. Here's Fusa. Oh, it's 2-1. And it's Fusa. The player who got his first two goals in the Italian First Division against Roma and hasn't scored since until now against the same opposition. And the goalkeeper, I don't think, even smelt it. So the free kick was just lofted in. The knockdown header came from Roma, but it fell perfectly for Fusa, and his volley was perfection. Well, you have to go back 5 years to find the last Italian First Division player to get 20 goals in a season. That was Michel Platini. But Serena needs one more to reach that mark. Oh, and it's set a goal up now for Diaz. Two inside 3 minutes. Diaz gets his second of the game, takes his tally for the season to 9. And Serena was forced a little bit wide by Bonini, but he had the control and the awareness to put it on a plate for Diaz.
Di Napoli, Carnevali. Di Napoli again, now Correca, the equaliser! Bologna's lead was short-lived, only 4 minutes. And Correca makes it 1-1. The goal superbly created. And the man who scored the winner in the UEFA Cup final first leg is Napoli's hero again. Fiorentina again demonstrating today their excellent form at home. This looks well created too. Dunga! It's goal number 3, and Como are in all sorts of trouble. Baggio to the substitute, Di Chiara. They tried to pull Dunga back, but didn't succeed. Well, it's a tight contest so far, but here's Barbas now on the break for Lecce, and supported now by Pacioccio. And it's there! First goal of this relegation battle to Lecce and Pacioccio. Pescara were caught out there by the pace of Barbas. Pacioccio kept going. Three defenders converge on him, but they couldn't stop him.
They asked too much of Serena that time. Ticella has sensed the moment to counter-attack himself with Zavarov in close attendance. Off goes Zavarov. And Rui Barros through the centre. Juventus have cracked the iron defence. Rui Barros got beyond Andy Bremer, got there before Zenga. Ferry couldn't redeem it all on the line itself. But an excellent pass from Ticella to open the way to a goal for Juventus, and Inter are behind.
And it's a chance for Napoli to launch an attack themselves. Maradona slotting it through. Correca, oh, he's away from Ferry. Round the goalkeeper too! Correca with goal number 3 for Napoli. And this man surely now ranks among the most accomplished strikers in the world. The vision there of Diego Maradona. And the composed finishing of Antonio Correca. Away from Marco Gianni. 3-0 Napoli. Here's the corner. Dunga fails to get it clear though. Bortolazzi and Berthold, a free header. The opening goal to Verona, and the marking then was dreadful. And our Verona heading now for the double over Fiorentina. Only their seventh away goal of the season. And Berthold heading it beyond the goalkeeper.
Mateus. This is Mattioli. He's got Serena up with him. And now Serena, a little chip. And it's 3-0. And Serena's scoring touch has stayed with him for yet another game. That's his 19th now, and it's come 19 minutes into the second half. Mattioli just prodded the pass wide. There was certainly a suspicion of offside until we saw there on the replay the player following in.
Here's the corner then from Giordano, and Casagrande, and he scored! He's had his problems with injuries, a long spell out of the side, but he's back now with a vengeance. That's Casagrande's third goal in three games, and how well he climbed. Junior, oh, he's done it again! Well, his repertoire from free kicks is quite astonishing. Around the wall and beyond the sprawling goalkeeper.
Andy Bremer with the centre, Ramon Diaz, and he scored! With an excellent goal from Ramon Diaz. The ball initially won by Nicola Berti. The cross from Andy Bremer. Ramon Diaz slips his man superbly, and a strike of excellent quality.
In their need might give Juventus more scope for their counter-attacking, but here's Serena, and the need is not so great now. Aldo Serena has emerged again as a leading figure in this fixture, and Bergami has gone across to join in the celebrations with Trapattoni. The travelling support from Milan are in raptures. Serena gets in another effective header. Tacconi was trying to shepherd it wide, praying it would go wide, and it was no more than a little back flick really, but he gets his angle sorted out perfectly, does Serena, and that's 1-1.
It's Correca combining with Maradona. Correca again. He jigs with delight. Maradona and Correca, the South American connection, works again. Maradona, who's not been on the field long, setting up Correca, and Napoli are ahead.
And this is Ferri. Stopping the ball reaching Mattioli for what would have been number six. Look how quickly Mateus has gone across to take the corner. Here's Mattioli again. Oh, it is six! Incredible! Bologna, leaden-legged, flat-footed, and Inter full of inspiration. There were two players unmarked at Mateus's adept corner, and Mattioli looped it in.
Win today would open up a 7-point lead for Inter. Serena, that's two, 2-0. Surely now that set point lead is going to become a reality. The ball deflected then from Bianchi's cross, but Serena, no mistake at all. Now Dunga, and he's picked out Bosco. Now Baggio, still going on, and it's there! Persistent play by Baggio, perceptive play, initially from Dunga. He found Bosco down the right. Como seemed to have enough defenders back to deal with the problem, but Baggio had other ideas. Pass one defender, pass two, now pass three, Paradisi struggling, and Baggio makes it 1-0.
Renica. Well, they've let Careca turn. Oh! At what cost? And Zenga, this time, has to pick it out of the back of the net, and he hasn't done that too often this season. It was a stunning shot from a player who's looked right from the first whistle here to be on top of his game. Antonio Careca with a dipping volley. Napoli lead. 9 minutes before half-time, they allowed him to turn and face the goal, and Inter will now be regretting that. It was a scorcher.
This, in fact, is the first time this season that Pisa have scored three times in a game. But Como, a full one back from Milton. Well, Pisa, without a win in six games before this one. I wonder if Como are on the verge now of staging a dramatic recovery. It was certainly well hit by Lewis Milton, and Grudina couldn't get there.
It's a long time in coming, this free kick. A minute now since the offence took place. It's going to be Mateus.
Oh, it's in!
Delay, because it's the goal that Inter believe will mean the championship. Scenes of unbridled celebration here, and after all the fuss, Mateus addressed himself to the task and smacked it through the defenders, and the goalkeeper had absolutely no chance. And the centre. Scorro. Well played. Oh, brilliant play. A terrific goal for Torino. And a vital psychological time. With 3 minutes left in the first half. A solo goal of high class here. Rodier had miscalculated to let Scorro get in behind him. There was no stopping him. Pass Fontolan and then slipping it over an advancing goalkeeper. And that has changed the complexion of things very much to Torino's advantage. They're back level 1-1.
Well, Ascoli have survived the first 10 minutes or so. Still under pressure here, Van Basten. Evani, and there's the first goal. Well, no surprise, Milan in such marvellous form. Van Basten laying it off into the path of Evani, and Ascoli in trouble now. Bonomi, and here's Mancini, he's onside, and surely he's not going to score from there. Well, he has. An amazing goal from Mancini. An inspired substitution by Sampdoria. Mancini with his second goal. Rossi committed. And for the most awkward of angles, Mancini has made it 2-0.
It's a Como free kick. Giancarlo Centi pondering as to what to do with it. Milton is lurking as well, but Chenti plays it deep. McCoppy's up well! Very well indeed! And the away jinx has struck at Torino already. A goal behind after only 4 minutes. A splendid leap by McCoppy. And this, after Como could have been trailing themselves, they're in front. And McCoppy, who made a bad mistake at Pescara last week, which cost Como victory, has started to try and put the record straight here.
Rijkaard. Now for Colombo. 3-1. And any hope now that Bologna had of picking up a point in this game has surely gone. 3-1 to AC Milan. Colombo with an explosive shot. Evani, and he's found Baresi. It's there! And Franco Baresi, the inspirational captain of Milan, has struck again. Two goals now in two matches for him. He scored last week against Como. He's done it again today.
Barb has to take it. Paolo Benedetti! What a leap! What a goal for Lecce! And a terrible blow for Torino. Well, they pushed him back to play a sweeper in this game from midfield. Always likely to nick a goal from midfield and to come up and a set play here with a magnificent header. Just look at it again. He timed the approach, got a running jump at it, but was able to get on top of the ball to head downwards.
Cerezo for Sampdoria. Now for Salsano. Trying his luck, and he scored! Salsano for Sampdoria. This usually sets off on his tour of the ground, as he often does when he celebrates a goal. And well, he might here. Cerezo, Salsano, or glance up, and beyond Schiavone. Dunga with the free kick. Fiorentina still a goal down. They're not now. Cucchi with the equaliser. A real lift for Fiorentina in their efforts to earn a European place next season. And this was supremely struck by Cucchi.
Benedetti is close to the ball, but I think you can put your money on Barbas to take it. Here he goes, and off the inside of the post, it's nestled into the back of the Torino net. And that may well be the final nail in the coffin. Marcheggiani, who is an inexperienced goalkeeper, remember, and one tempers criticism with that. But I think he was frightened that Barbas was going to go to the left as we look to the goalkeeper's right. And he was in a pretty central position, and in fact wrong-footed by the direction of the shot. Marcheggiani was starting to go to his right. The ball went to the left and he couldn't get there. And he was unlucky when it hit the post and still went in.
Bremer. Here's Bianchi. Morello, the substitute, Bergomi! Well, he's made it this time. He's been threatening to score all the game as Bergomi, and that's his first of the season. And the champions are back on level terms. Morello touching it off, and Bergomi making it 1-1. Here's Milton, always looking to take on the opposition, and he is here. Simone back into the path of Milton. Now can he score? He has. 1-0 to Como. And that was an inspired piece of play by the Brazilian Luis Milton. And what a vital goal it could prove to be too in this relegation battle. Milton striding on, swapping passes there with Simone. And as Gatta committed himself, Milton steered it in. Good play by Bremer. Such a vital cog in the Inter machine. And so too is Diaz. But he scores goals like this. Bremer picking him out. And Diaz, who had a goal disallowed earlier in the game, has better reward this time.
Cravero to the left. They do the number 11. 5 in the wall. It's going to be Edu. Oh! Fantastic! And the Brazilians have really made their mark for Torino in this game. Look at the height in the free kick and how it dipped. Impossible to stop. The swerve and the spin imparted here was simply astonishing. The ball seemed to be going over the bar. It hit the underside of the bar and bounced into the net.
Well, Inter finished as champions for the 13th time, 9 years since their last triumph. They dropped only 10 points all season, losing just 2 games. 67 goals scored, only 19 conceded. 11 points ahead of second-place Napoli. Very impressive statistics. The final relegation issue wasn't settled until the last day of the season. Como, Pisa, Pescara and Torino go down. Torino for only the second time in their distinguished history. Genoa, Bari, Udinese and Cremonese come up. Aldo Serena of Inter finished top scorer with 22 goals. Careca of Napoli ended with 19, caught by Marco van Basten, who struck 8 in his last 4 matches. Goalscorers of a very high calibre abound in Italian football, proving that it's not just about defensive discipline.